initiative.
We're out here to do initiative.
Yo.
The thing that you have to be aware of is that they're all sick children. They're really, really sick. But they come to camp and they really have an opportunity just to be kids. And we make sure that they're kids and we provide the activities that let them do that.
Awesome! Good job, Lindsay. Keep it up.
At our opening ceremony, we lit a torch. Flame to me means a sign of strength, courage, hope, and we hope to carry that flame, and I know we're going to carry that flame throughout our camp and beyond.
I love you, you love me.
Changes I've seen in the children, especially the children who came back from last year's camp, they knew what camp was, what they were in for when they got off the bus, but we had several new campers coming out for this first year. They were a little bit more timid, but in a few days we've been here, they've opened up, and these kids feel right at home today, and they're really in a good space right now.
We making new friends and inviting kids to our groups, and it's not so scary. I was in remission for about a week, and then I had another relapse. It wasn't bad.
They're treading water for 5 minutes to end their white bead, which means that they can go on any of the toys out in the lake. They can go water skiing, tubing.
Some of the activities that the children participate in are a lot of team sports. We've done a lot of soccer this year, basketball. We were on the archery range earlier today. We were rock climbing. Tomorrow we hope to go on the high ropes course.
I was very scared because I am scared of heights. But I learned that I can actually do something if I really don't think that I can. Because I was like doing something and I didn't think I would ever do it, but I did.
I was the most scared at the X walk up there because I almost fell off, but I didn't. So I learned that it's good to be careful about things, not too careful, but still careful, and always double check things. Yeah, I didn't think I could do it, but I did anyway, and I ended up doing pretty well.
Kids that I see, you know, they're often sick when I'm actually seeing them, and they're all obviously it's in a different role that they're the patients here, they're in charge and they do all the activities, and it's good to see a different side of each of the kids.
Life with Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis obviously poses a lot of challenges, things that other people don't have to deal with, like having to go to the bathroom or missing school a lot, and you can see that these kids are facing some of that right now, especially this morning when we checked them in. You could see all of the different medications that they took. And you know that that makes them different from other kids. And as difficult as it is to be a parent and let your kid go, sometimes they really need it. They need to experience life beyond you and your help. They need to be able to experience all the joys of childhood. And part of that is camping. And that's what this is about, is really letting these kids who otherwise have to endure so much have that piece of childhood that they might just be missing.
This would have been amazing. He's too old for this camp now. He's 23. If he had been younger when he was diagnosed, if he had been as bad, this would have been a really good experience for him. To be with other kids, to see that a lot of other people had his problems, instead of being always the only, to be the only sick person in a healthy world is pretty tough. So this is just an amazing experience for the kids.
So we gave Julia the greatest giggle award.
Some kids take 2 pills, some kids take 30 pills, and that's definitely no exaggeration. We have several kids that do take that many, and we have several kids that are on tube feeding, and they bring their own pumps, and we get those set up. We have several kids who have colostomies and need care from that aspect. We have kids who receive suppositories several times a day. So lots of different medications. Each child is an individual. You have to constantly be checking and rechecking, making sure that the children have taken their meds, that they have shown up, because there are kids that don't want to take their medication. So you have to kind of be on top of that.
When each and every one of you are behind the eight ball, you need to make sure you have a game plan. You need to make sure you're positive.
One of our activities is Peter Nielsen's Junior Physical Fitness Academy. Peter and his staff come out during the week and do physical exercises with the children. And then Peter comes out and talks about nutrition and how to deal with your problems. And hearing it from Peter and seeing his success stories, the children find it quite interesting.
If everyone had a message on someone that was just diagnosed, what would you tell them?
Don't be afraid, there's people just like you.
I tell them to come here because it's been a lot of fun. It's a great experience trying to hang out with some kids that have the same disease as me.
There's a lot to be gained from the kids coming to the camp. Most of the kids in school don't have any other friends who have this. And this is actually a place for them to start a new persona, that the kids here can be, act themselves. They don't have to worry about somebody's going to make fun of them from going to the bathroom or having a scar in their belly.
I learned to put more heart into the sports that I play, try some new activities, and I'm not letting my Crohn's disease stop me from doing anything that I can't do.
I learned that I can believe in myself, and if I try, then I can succeed, and my colitis won't pull me back on things.
The kids are so appreciative, and I've really kind of learned a lot from them, a lot about myself, and it's kind of made my trip worthwhile. This has been by far the best week I've spent at camp.
If it wasn't for this camp, these children wouldn't have an opportunity to do the things that they're being provided for here. They're being able to do these things is because we're looking after these children and providing for medical care, the right nutrition, and we just have a good volunteer staff helping these kids along the way. We're here for the children.
Because it was named after my daddy, and he really would have loved this.
It's hard to let you go in the Father's hands. We